been going through a lot. I am facing so many problems, just like you are this morning. But let me remind you this morning, Jehovah is his name. Mighty warrior, great in battle. You have already won over your addiction with God. You have already won the battle with God. Hallelujah. All you need to do this morning is to stand firm on the word of the Lord. In the midst of
Oh, animar. Vamos a ir por para uno.
Selling the possessions and goods they gave to anyone as he had need.
Bianana ufuka tau, kuna ungai api, wenaume a, petufa gihe kakai, ufuka tau, gihe na umasiwa. Wakurindo wahe, kiva besono no ge besono tahanima.
2 Corinthians 6.
Koya e ombia e eku wahe wahe e bomungini. Kufuhai o itamata o guduma o.
Last week we spoke about ways in which you can stand firm.
And these
are ways in which you can see or you can testify to a person who is devoted and standing firm.
You'll
notice in this scripture is a golden truth for all of us that we should all grasp and understand.
Well,
he holds all things to give to us generously. Tells how he gave his
victory.
There wasn't a second there's one and only begotten son. So that we could be the way we are today. We
have
the opportunity to stand in the what we are being taught this year. And you'll notice someone who stands still, they are someone who gives.
Hallelujah.
When you hear the word giving, a lot of us
were itching.
And we think, oh, well, everything in this church was just to get money.
You know,
to have fun. It is true, it's a fact that every church needs funds to run, and so does a family. In order for a family to run, for a church of God to
run,
funds in order to do the work. And here you see the apostles, the followers of Christ. They sold it and shared it amongst all who had need. If we were to see that happen nowadays, we'd think something's wrong. But these were people who were steadfast in the teachings. And you'll notice in society, if you were to check it out, if you were to seek out the truth, the richest people on this earth descendants of givers, people who sold out all they earned to give to the poor. Nowadays, it's important for
us to
be
able to get
a house. Praise the Lord, that is a great advancement for all of us to own a house. I hear the believers of Christ, they believed upon
Him.
They didn't worry about the future and what was to happen. It tells that they understanding that everything they had owned, they were selling. And that's the principle of the kingdom of God, is to be generous.
principal of the Kahaya and I, Mooni, for our tour, he gave Lama Hatamata, they gave Lama Hashishin, and we come up with principal of our tour.
This is a principle of God and a principle of His word, and no church and no belief can cover it. The world sees it as collect as much as you can to get rich.
Right.
But let me tell you, the principle of God is the opposite. You give, the more you give, the more you receive.
Corinthians 9.
Verse 6, 2 Corinthians. So here Paul is writing to the Corinthians. Here he is encouraging the people. It is not what they have in their hands.
But
the more they give, and the more they give, Paul says, remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. And whoever sows generously will also reap
sparingly.
So what's the seed? This church is our seed is to give. To keep giving. Are you able to give to
him?
If he is the one who gave all that he gave, tells that the people who were devoted to Christ and following Him, they sold all they had and they gave. I believe this is the year for us to plant those seeds. This is the year that we have heaps of seeds to plant. It's not just fruit giving. There are seeds in all areas of our
lives.
In order for us to gain heaps in this life, we need to have heaps of seeds. These seeds to plant into our children. Seeds to plant in ourselves so that we know what we're
going
to do. Seeds to plant to know that you're going to
reap what you want.
And that's the seed of what you
want to do.
Where Paul says, the less you
seed,
And if we do that, I believe God will bless us.
Principally, or to have the full for life, but like you get the full again.
That's a principle of God's word. The more you give, the more you will receive.
Hallelujah. Right.
I've noticed in my company that I've been running. In the last 4 years, I chose which seeds I was going
to
plant. And I saw the areas where I would gain the most, so I wanted to plant them. And the jobs that gave me a little in return, I was hesitant to give more to that. And over the last 3 years, I started to see where I was seeing it
going.
It didn't matter what little I was
paying. que pedía.
Just like the time of humor to
God. Que todo el mundo es para que tú podías.
It's not a household that rewards that seed needs to be planted. And I've asked forgiveness from God in my
hesitation.
And I was reaping that where there were days and weeks where I was working because I was planting the seeds.
And in the amount of
time
plant the seeds.
Whatever you can do, do it. Because you will reap them.
In
verse
7
and 10. Tells us each man should give what he has decided in his heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. So give according to what is decided in your heart.
Hallelujah.
The choice is yours. The more you give.
In
verse 8 it talks
about
and God is able to make all grace abound to you.
We
serve a good God.
Hear me clearly.
Where we see, we choose to praise
them.
Know that you
will
receive the
fruit.
The more seeds you plant, the more you're going to receive. Some people are like, oh, we're we're going to give everything we got.
I share with all the pastors.
15,000 was spent on all the preachers that came through our church
last year.
And where does that money come from?
Can you
clearly
realize that?
Can
you
clearly
realize that?
30,000 was our mission given. I'm sure you all understand. That was way more than any of us earned last year.
Some people there say, "Oh, sick man."
And they're thinking, "Oh,
talk about money, sick man."
Always.
About the money. How we talk about the money? Talk no a get a guy go to a pay. Pay to life or go to a go face a cow. To life or go to a go pay go money. To pay go money now.
And he tells people and other people, not his wife, think he's crazy.
Where
do you get this money from?
Yeah.
And so, the one who believes it, he holds it all.
Can he hang up?
Everyone knows what I speak
about.
That's the seed I'm
talking.
And they all see it like, oh, he takes us everywhere. But I've already said that we're going to bless the church and buy all, and I'm going to buy all the cement and all the bricks needed.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's the point. That's the usefulness of
the mission.
Last year, the end of last year, towards the beginning of this year. And I see God
release
His
blessing.
How beautiful the family is. I see how God is providing
for you.
Hear me clearly.
That God is
to stand prayer to be devoted to teaching. We must give.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Como fue así, verso 35.
Verse 15. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise
be to God for his love that he gives to us. Please stand. I want you this morning to understand. Is one of the well-known Pentecostal pastors here. And he has visited here and he has seen things that he has not seen in other churches. And he declared that he knows that God is moving in this
place. He
shares how he walks in our doors and he feels the atmosphere
of God. And shared
his experience of meeting those who are in our media team and working through this process. I saw his face and he was crying. And I shared with him how the people who came, the team who came to help us
set it up with Tom.
A lot of times they wanted other churches in Tonga and Tonga work to do this kind of meeting. But God touched the man of God through our step of faith and working through this as
God's life.
You see, the problem with money
is that
you have a problem in life. And you see, God has given us that resource to reach out to other lives. You got to release it, you got to give it. You know you. Think about your year this year. How much you're going to give to God's
work.
I know because I am the pastor. I know everything that is happening in your life. As the man shares this last song with us, which is available to you. If you are facing financial difficulty, if you
are
struggling, come to God.
Hallelujah.